is John Cola with growingyourgreens.com. Today we have another exciting episode for you. Today I'm traveling. I'm here in South Florida in Broward County in Southwest Ranches. It's like right near Fort Lauderdale. The reason for this episode is because I'm at the Rare Fruit and Vegetable. Very important. We got an underlined Vegetable Council of Broward County, Inc. So this is actually a nonprofit organization. And, you know, I've visited many different fruit councils around Florida in the past at their different events and whatnot and plant sales, right? And all of them have meetings and are a great thing to join if you live in an area that has one. And I encourage you guys to join your local fruit council, but I really love the Broward Fruit and Vegetable Council the most for two reasons. Number one, they include vegetables in the name, and they focus on growing a lot of fruit trees, but also they're growing vegetables and have a demonstration garden. That's the other thing I love about this council, is that this council actually has a property, whereas other councils do not, where they actually grow things in the ground, experiment and find out what works and what doesn't work, as well as they're able to hold their plant sales here twice a year, open to the public in the spring and the fall only. That being said, if you guys live in Broward County, I would encourage you guys to join the Rare Fruit and Vegetable Council as a member, right? You pay $35 at present time. And then if you do that, then you have access to buying some of the fruit trees and other plants that they have available twice a week on any Wednesday or Saturday. In addition, you could get a newsletter. You could come to the monthly meetings. They have fruit tastings. They have propagation classes and different kinds of workshops you guys could learn from. I mean, it's just, if you guys are into growing food in Broward County, join them. It's going to be the best $35 you ever spent. And the other thing you guys are going to get, if you guys join them as a member, you could basically get hands-on training. So even if you never gardened, grew a fruit tree, grew a vegetable before, and you're interested in it, join them as a member, and then you could come here and work with them on their work days, which are probably Wednesday and Saturdays, and get hands-on experience where they'll guide you to get you to volunteer and help them in their garden. But at the same time, you're going to have access to people that know a lot about growing vegetables and fruit here in Broward County. So yeah, and it's all about community and, you know, connecting with others that are into the same and have the same passions as you do. And I talked to many of the different people here, some of the members, and they're just great people. So anyways, in this episode, I'm going to take you guys inside, show you guys what they got growing on here. More importantly, I'm going to focus on the vegetables. Because, you know, we are here in June, and many people in South Florida think, oh, June, you can't grow vegetables in June. It's too hot in Florida, right? And they think the time to grow vegetables, being from the northern climates, is in the wintertime when that's their summer season here, right? But there are things you can grow even in the summertime here for vegetables, and that's what I'm going to show you guys today at the Rare Fruit and Vegetable Council of Broward County, but also learn about some of the rare fruit trees they have as well. So let's come inside. All right, so you guys can see this area behind me where basically they got a structure, like a shade structure, and then they got signs with different rows. They got like five rows, and all these rows have different kinds of fruit trees, rare fruit trees, even some vegetables down some of these rows that when they have a sale, a public sale, once again, twice a year, the public could come in and buy these fruit trees and other plants. Now, if you guys become a member, then you could come here any Wednesday or Saturday and buy the plants. And I'm just going to go over to one row to share with you guys just some of the plants that you could buy if you're here. All right, so we're looking at the nursery here, and they got all kinds of pineapples, dragon fruits, different sapotes, abayus, cashews, ice cream beans, gooseberries, carambola, lime, sapotes, star fruit, macadamia nuts, jackfruit. They got mangoes, jambu, wax jambus, avocados, all kinds of tropical plants that are really grow good here in Florida. They've tested many of them. They propagated themselves. Some of them they bring in from other nurseries, and then they offer them to you at really good prices because, once again, this is a nonprofit, and, you know, selling plants is one of the ways, aside from the memberships, they have the money to have this space and keep it running. So once again, if you guys are looking for plants, yeah, join as a member. You could come here and have access to buying some of these amazing plants they have here. All right, so as you guys can see, we got some jackfruit here. This is one of my favorite fruits in the entire world. Behind, I don't know if you guys can see that, they got a dragon fruit, and then behind over there, they got mangoes. So this is basically, for the most part, it's an orchard with demonstration trees planted that produce fruit so they could find out what grows well, what's attacked by bugs, and all these kinds of things so that you guys could get the right plants. They got a few mosquitoes around here too. It's raining today. But yeah, so we're not really going to cover the fruits in this episode. You guys could come here, join as a member, and they could tour you around and show you guys all the different fruit trees they got. But my focus today is on the vegetables as I kill some mosquitoes. All right, so this is the entrance to the vegetable garden. You guys can see they got a mango tree that's basically kind of hanging down in front of the entrance to the vegetable garden that we're going to head into. You know, once again, it's Fruit and Vegetable Council here in Broward County. Let's head into the vegetable garden to show you guys what are they growing this summer. All right, so the first tip for you guys is, you guys can see they have raised beds that are somewhat rather tall, maybe like a little bit more than a foot tall. And they have iguanas here. Some are like super huge, so like they have to keep the iguanas out. Maybe you have other pests and rodents and things near you. And they basically built a PVC frame, and they put just like the mesh wire on there, wire cloth on there with tie wraps to hold it in place. And this is just one big frame, so if they need to, so the iguanas can't get in, but if they need to move it, this is relatively light to pick up. And they could just pick it up with two people and move it off so they could work the bed and then put it back on so that the pests can't get it. So this was very important. Otherwise, you know, the iguanas would basically tear up and eat everything. Maybe you got birds that dig up your ceilings, right? You need to do something like this. Depending on what creature you have, you may not need to put the wire, but you could put some kind of netting on there. But it all depends on where you live and the creatures that are eating your vegetables. So now I want to show you guys some heat-loving vegetables that they're growing here in the garden. Includes the onions. Looks like more like onion chives kind of thing. And they also got some okra growing that's really growing well. Okra really loves the humidity and loves the heat. I'd probably also say eggplant's probably going to do pretty good here as well, although I don't see any planted. The other thing that they're doing here is that they experiment with many different vegetables to find out what grows good and what doesn't grow good. And that's the only way they're going to learn, is by trying different plants and different seeds they get from places like Rare Seeds and whatnot, rareseeds.com, right? So I love that they do that. Hopefully they'll be able to post online like the trials that they've done. Hey, this worked, but this didn't work, so that you guys could know what worked and what didn't work. The only way to know that is actually come down here and speak with the vegetable gardeners here. I met two of them today. They're really nice people, and I met two of them today, and they're really nice people. But in this bed, they're growing the heirloom peanut, and behind they have some kind of tomatoes. I'm not sure the variety, but of course, here in South Florida, I would recommend growing the Everglades tomato that produces reliably, even through the heat. All right, so this is a new bed they planted, and this is kind of fun to me to learn what they're planting. Actually, they just germinated, and they're called guar. So if you hear a guar gum, it's added as like a, I guess, stabilizer maybe to different food products, but this is actually a bean that makes the guar gum that you may have seen in different food products. So what they do is they harvest them when they're young and tender. The beans are not formed, and then basically they'll cook them and you could eat them, and they're probably good in some kind of resistant starch or good fiber for your microbiome. So this is a new one to me that you know, they grow reliably here and will do well based on talking to one of the gardeners that grows this very bean plant at home. All right, so another vegetable they're growing in our nice long raised bed in little rows are the sweet potatoes. You know, the sweet potatoes make the sweet potato tuber that you guys could eat, but more importantly, they also grow the sweet potato greens that you can eat raw or cooked, just like, you know, spinach or whatever. And so that's really cool. They got a bunch of these here. I guess they got them protected because maybe the iguanas would get them. I don't protect my sweet potatoes, and I love growing them. I have some really cool varieties that actually have purple leaves and purple potatoes, but also purple leaves and orange sweet potatoes as well. They're gonna do really good. So here's the thing, guys, like many people think of like growing crops as annual crops. Those are the crops you need to plant and let them grow, and then you harvest them and then they're done for the season, and then you need to replant them next year, right? That's one kind of crop, but the other crop, especially very important here in Florida, are the perennial vegetables that literally you could plant once and either they will reseed on their own or they'll just keep growing year round or stay alive under the ground and then pop up the following year or just stay alive year round and provide you a good source of food. This is very underemphasized, unfortunately, in traditional gardening circles, and that's why I try to emphasize them on my channel, because these are really the crops you guys want to grow if you guys live here in South Florida, so that you could be eating vegetables and leafy green vegetables out of your garden in the summer, even when it's really hot. So sweet potato vine could be considered a perennial vegetable here because it doesn't get too cold to kill the tubers at the end of the year, and they should just come back every year, maybe even grow year-round depending on how cold it gets. And now I want to show you guys some more perennial vegetables that literally you could plant once and have forever. All right, so right here are more perennial vegetables you guys could grow. And basically things like turmeric and ginger, cardamom, which are all in the same ginger family of plants, are something you could grow. And then you could harvest them. You know, many people don't know that some of the leaves can also be edible on some of these plants as well. And basically they'll come back next year if the ground doesn't freeze and they don't basically rot under the ground. These are some of my favorite plants because they are quite medicinal. If you guys are interested more about learning about ginger and turmeric, link down below the other video I made here in South Florida where I visited a turmeric and ginger farm. One of my favorite perennial vegetables that I even grow in Las Vegas, and I'm able to keep it alive year-round, even during light freezes without protection, because I've been lazy these days. Sometimes I'll put Christmas tree lights on it. Here you wouldn't have to do that, is the Gynera procumbens, or longevity spinach. You guys can see this whole bed, except for one corner they cleared out, is all longevity spinach. You plant this plant once, and then forever you will have leafy greens to eat out of your garden. This is like a no-brainer. You could plant this like underneath fruit trees to act as ground cover, and you know, because it'll grow kind of in part shade, but you know, in this shady spot kind of underneath a mango tree, it's doing really well. And the coolest thing about this plant is literally to propagate it, you just take off a clipping, a cutting of the tips. I'll pop off some of the leaves. And then basically what you do is you pop this in wet soil, keep it wet, it'll grow roots, and it'll basically grow a whole new plant. And of course, all this could be eaten raw. Mmm. Delicious. So aside from the Gynera procumbens, or longevity spinach, they also have the Okinawan spinach. This is related to another Gynera, I think it's Gynera bicolor. And actually this one prefers more of the shade, so I think this is a little bit more too sunny area, so it's not really doing really well. This would really do much better underneath the shade of a tree, in my opinion. This could also be propagated the same way. It does not grow as quickly as the Gynera procumbens, but I like it because generally on the underside it'll have like purple leaves, so it has more anthocyanin content that can be a health beneficial phytochemical made by the plants. Of course, here is another leafy green that's growing really well here. I'm trying to grow it this season in Las Vegas as an annual. Maybe it'll hang out as a perennial. I'm not thinking that, because it just gets a little bit too cold, but this is called the CISO spinach. I believe also it's called Brazilian spinach, and you guys can see this is just taking over this whole bed right here. You guys can see it's taking over pretty much this whole bed, so if you guys want the most productive greens, let's say grow the CISO and the longevity spinach. These guys look the most productive by far. Now, aside from those spinaches, there's even more spinaches, and I just want to comment real quick here. While it is called quote-unquote spinach, these are not related to the standard spinach that we know and love. That's in a whole different family of plants. These are just known as spinach because they make edible greens that can be eaten like a salad, you know, in greens. So it's not like related, and the taste is definitely different, but some of these flavors are amazing, and I encourage you guys to expand your palate, eat more different varieties of foods, get better microbiome diversity when you eat different foods, and get different, more importantly, vitamins, minerals, and plant compounds such as the polyphenols that every plant produces a little bit different, so you guys can be healthy because of it. Plus, you know, you may have success with one of these spinaches, but the other one may fail, so plant one of everything and see which one does the best for you. All right, so this spinach is actually one of my favorites, and I'm growing it this year in my garden. I grow it every year as an annual crop. Here it may grow year-round. But they also go to seed. They make these nice little purple berries here. But this is known as the Malabar spinach. This one grows as a vine, so they basically growing it up like a fencing, you know, like a tomato, old tomato cage thing right here. And it looks like it's nice and happy with lots of leaves to eat. So the last spinach I'm gonna share with you guys today, they have in just little pots, and these ones basically go to flower and drop little small seeds, and they always come up in little pots around my garden, around my house. This is known as the Suriname spinach, also known as Jewel of Au Pair. And so this also has nice succulent leaves. You can eat the little tips off as well. And I'm just gonna go ahead and pick some greens. And they're quite delicious also. One of the cool things they're doing here is actually they have a little area with like a little pond, right? And these have basically mosquito fish in there. They basically eat the mosquito larvae when the mosquitoes like lay the eggs in the water. And also attracts beneficial insects and, you know, other creatures into the area so that it could actually help defend against the pests they may get in the garden. If you guys can't dig a pond in your area, I want to show you guys a simple way you guys could lower the mosquito count in your area by using actually an old hot tub like they're doing here. All right, so you guys can see they got a, basically an old hot tub that I guess is no longer functioning. They probably got it for free or cheap, and they filled it up with water. They're growing some edible lotus in there, but also they basically put in the mosquito fish in here. So they basically have an aquarium or a fish tank with the mosquito fish. And then basically this attracts the mosquitoes. Like, hey mosquitoes, look, you have a place to lay your eggs in, right? The mosquitoes lay the eggs, and unbeknownst to the mosquitoes, the mosquito fish are in there and then basically eat the little larvae. And then that helps to control the mosquito population. They find that, you know, the closer you are to this little area, the less mosquitoes are flying around. But I don't know if that's exactly true, but this has definitely reduced the numbers. So this is something to have definitely if you're in the tropics. Have little pools where you could keep mosquito fish that will help keep the mosquito numbers down. Use nature to fight nature. So I love that they're doing that here at the Broward Rare Fruit and Vegetable Council. So I'm getting rained out here in Southwest Ranches in Florida here, just a little bit after noon here, and the guys got to go home. And so I got to finish this video, plus my camera's getting wet. I don't want to fry due to all the rain. But I want to bring you guys this last vegetable that I want you guys to grow, and it's actually not a little vegetable plant. It's a vegetable tree. This is known as the drumstick tree, also known as moringa. You guys can see this tree is huge. It just basically, any of the leaves that the tree makes, guys, you can eat. They also have anti-cancer properties. They're so nutritious, more nutritious than kale, they say. All these things. You could also eat the drumsticks it form. You could eat the seeds. You could eat the flowers of this tree. And I've even heard you could eat the roots of the tree as well. And this tree will basically grow year-round here in South Florida, depending on where you are. It may die back a little bit in the winter and then just come back to life the following spring. But this is one of the easiest vegetables I want you guys to grow. It is so health beneficial. It helps with your phase 2 liver detoxification. You know, so I'm not recommending drinking alcohol, but if you do, you want to eat some moringa leaves or juice some leaves, link down below to that video, so you guys can help your liver be healthy, right? So yeah, hopefully in this episode, you guys learned about some of the perennial vegetables and some of the annual vegetables that are growing here at the Rare Fruit and Vegetable Council in Broward County. I encourage you guys, if you live in Broward County, to join them as a member, and you guys want to learn more about them or even join as a member online, you can check them out at rfavcbroward.org is their website. Well, we'll pop it up right there on the screen if you guys want to join the Rare Fruit and Vegetable Council here of Broward County. It's been an amazing time I've had here in this short episode today. And if you guys like this video, want more videos here when I come back next time, hey, give this video a big thumbs up. Also tell the guys here that, hey, I saw you guys on the John Kohler, and that's why I'm here. That's why I'm joining as a member. They'll appreciate me a little bit more and help you out to get you those rare fruit and vegetables and teach you guys the knowledge you know with the different classes, the grafting classes. They even have seed exchanges and all these things. It's really good to just be in the network, in the know, to meet with other people that have been doing this for a long time and have basically be able to tap into their knowledge so that you don't have to go through the school of hard knocks like I did. So yeah, thumbs up to this place for having the demonstration gardens here, keeping it up, and all the volunteers that work hard to make this is what it is today. Also, if you guys know people in Broward County, hey, send them a link to this video so that they could watch it and they could learn about this amazing place here in Southwest Ranches. Also, be sure to click that subscribe button right down below so you don't miss out on my new upcoming episodes. I'm coming out 5 to 7 days. You never know where I show up or what you'll be learning on my YouTube channel. And make sure you click the bell so you get notified as my new videos come out. I got a couple more videos coming out. Me here in South Florida and visiting other cool nurseries and places that I visited on my trip this time. Finally, be sure to check out past episodes. The past episodes are a wealth of knowledge. I'll put some links down below to some videos I made here in the past in South Florida, some of my favorite episodes, as well as some of the other episodes that I've referenced in this video as well. So with that, my name is John Kohler with growingyourgreens.com. We'll see you next time, and until then, remember, keep on growing.